Bakker. Heart disease, it's very big today. A lot of people end up passing away from strokes or heart disease. So new research now conducted at the new university in Colorado by a postdoctoral Dr. Brunch, a very interesting study I've just been reading up on, showing that when you change the microbiome of older mice, you can actually reduce their ability for them to develop toxic compounds in their gut called TMAO, which we'll talk about in a minute, leading to heart disease, all right, and stroke. So what this postdoctoral doctor did, this professor, what she did is she got hold of two groups of mice. And she basically cleaned out their gut with, well, they wiped out their gut using a broad spectrum antibiotic. Not a nice thing to do to give the mice, but they gave them, these mice, this antibiotic. They wiped out their gut bacteria in the old mice and the new mice. And what they found was very interesting with the older mice. They found that the older mice didn't have the same amount of toxic compounds in their gut that older mice normally have. You know, in fact, their health improved remarkably. And in terms of their circulation and heart, it was almost as healthy as the young mouse. They couldn't work out why, until they discovered that the gut bacteria of the older mice had changed with the broad spectrum antibiotic. Now, we're not suggesting for one minute that antibiotics are the fountain of youth. In fact, they kill more people, in my opinion, than they actually heal. So they create so much carnage. But this is just an example to show you that when you alter the gut bacteria, you can also alter parameters of health. And it shows you how health is, even heart disease can be linked with gut health. So TMAO, or trimethylamine oxide, is a very toxic compound. So by the time you get to about my age, 60, you've got a 70% chance of having TMAO. And in fact, when you're 80, 85, it's only, I think, about 10, 15% of people actually are free of TMAO, whereas 90% have it. So this change comes about as the gut ages. The bacteria age, and you get certain groups of bacteria, and they start shifting, and particularly in absence of good bacteria, the production of these toxic compounds increases, which of course increases your risk of stroke. So very interesting. So what this professor is saying is he's saying that people can achieve a very similar thing at home by making sure as they get older, particularly my age, like 60 plus, they start consuming kefir and yogurt and kombucha and putting things into the diet that actually boost up the gut health rather than kill the gut health. Many people, older people like me, are already taking statin drugs and high blood pressure medications and aspirin, and they get flu shots, they get all of this stuff. Is it any wonder that their gut slowly declines, you know? So there you have it. Keep your gut in great shape as you get older. Keep looking at cultured and fermented foods. Keep active, and you may well have a chance of staving off, you know, one of the biggest killers of older people, is circulatory problem, heart disease and stroke. Don't forget to click on the link below if you want my free report in the description box. Thank you.